welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new. My name is Jillian, and in today's video, I thought I would do something a little different. I've never done a video like this, but I thought since I'm about to go on a short mini road trip for a mini vacation, I thought I would share with you guys a few items that I like to take on the road with me when I am taking a long road trip with my kids, because any mom knows that when you take a long road trip with little ones, it can be a little hard and they can get a little antsy and upset. And yeah, just trying to keep them entertained and content is key to a successful long road trip. So our road trip is going to be about 7 to 8 hours, depending on traffic and depending on how long we spend on getting lunch and making stops. So it'll probably be closer to 8 hours, but that is how long we will be in the car for our road trip. So I thought I would share with you guys a few things that I'll be taking on the road with me. And then at the end, I will share a few other things that I am not taking on the road, but are also great options to take if you guys are traveling with little ones. All right, guys, before I start showing everything, I do want to apologize. This lighting is probably going to be going in and out. The sun keeps on coming in and out, so I'm sorry if the lighting is not the best, but we're going to head in to everything that I'll be bringing with my kids. The first thing is probably the most obvious thing that a lot of parents bring with them anytime they're traveling with little ones, and that is a tablet. So the kids will be bringing their tablets with them on this road trip. We have a bunch of apps that we have downloaded that they can play games and use. We even have one like artsy one that they can like draw and color on. And then we will also probably purchase them a movie so they can watch a movie on their tablet. And I also would suggest, if you have more than one kid, to probably bring headphones, because I know Ryan and he'll probably start complaining that he hears Madison's tablet or our radio is too loud. So having headphones so they can just listen to their own movie or show or whatever they're doing, playing a game, and they won't be interrupted by whatever else is going on in the background. So headphones and a tablet is the first thing that we will be bringing on this 8-hour road trip with us. And next thing, since we're talking about a tablet and like movies and stuff, I'm going to be bringing a lot of DVDs, just because we do have a DVD player in the car. So if maybe Madison doesn't want to actually like hold and use her tablet, I can put a movie on for her, or even Ryan as well. So this is one of them that I'll be bringing with me just because it's educational and they love it. And this is by Leapfrog. It's Letter Factory. So it teaches them letters. I think it also teaches them like numbers and stuff, but I'll be bringing this one. And then I have already some in the car. I have just like typical cartoons that they like Peppa Pig and Mickey Mouse and stuff. So we'll be bringing those as well. And if you don't have a DVD player in your car, I know Amazon sells a lot of affordable travel DVD players that you can just like attach to the back of like your seat in your car. So I'll try to find a few of those for you and I'll link it down below. So DVDs is another thing that we will be bringing. Next thing I'm going to be bringing is these notepads. I have two of them, but I'm only showing you guys one. But I got this from Target. It was only $3, and basically it's just a notepad that has a ton of just blank white paper so they can draw and doodle and color on here, do whatever they want. Right now Ryan's very into like making a list and to-do list and checklists and stuff, so he'll probably be doing that in here as well. But just bringing like plain paper for them to like draw and color on is always great, so I'll be bringing this for the kids as well. Since we're in the topic of like drawing and coloring, I'm going to show you guys coloring books. We will be bringing a lot of coloring books. These are the three that I've picked so far for them. I'll probably bring like one or two other ones just so they can have options. And some of these coloring books also have like activities for them to do. Like this one is a coloring book and activity book. So yeah, just bringing coloring books for them so they can color, and is always a great option as well. And then I have this, which is where I'm going to put all of like their crayons and markers in, instead of bringing like their big box of like Crayola markers or crayons. I just thought I would get this. I bought this from Dollar Tree, and I'm just gonna stick in some crayons and markers in there for them. And then I'm also going to be bringing this that I bought from Dollar Tree as well. I thought this was really cool. So I usually buy these like play and go, I don't even know what they're called, but like on the go, like little sets. And I usually get the one that has like the coloring book, the crayons, and I think stickers. I've never seen this one before, but it's a wood. It has like a wooden board, it says inside. So it says it has 4 coloring boards, 3 washable markers, 24 fun pad, page fun pad, and then 25 stickers. So basically it's, I think it's wooden because it's hard. So Ryan can color it and then it pops out and it's like a little figurine that he can play with. But I also like that it came with stickers and also a little, fun pad that I guess has coloring books in it. I'm not sure, but I just thought that was really cool. So I'll be bringing that with us on the road trip as well. Another thing I will be bringing is this huge book. My aunt actually purchased this for Ryan for his birthday, and it's a National Geographic Kids workbook. So I like that it's educational, but he also can have fun. So he can draw and color in here. There's a bunch of activities he can do. Like I said, a lot of it is educational, which is great. I think it even comes with stickers. Yeah, it comes with stickers. So it's just a bunch of fun things that he can do in the car, and it's really thick, so he'll have a lot of fun with that. Another thing I will be bringing is a lot of books. My kids love books, especially Ryan. Ryan has always been into books ever since he was a baby. He's always liked flipping through books, but now that he is actually learning how to read, he's even more into books. So I let him pick out a few books that he can bring, and he picked out this one. This is a Scholastic book we bought at one of the book fairs. He's obsessed with dinosaurs, so I like that he can learn about a bunch of different dinosaurs, but he can also, you know, read. So we bring in this dinosaur book, and then right now he is very, very into Dr. Seuss books. So these are three books he wants to bring. So he's going to be bringing this Green Eggs and Ham one. He'll be bringing this One Fish, Two Fish Dr. Seuss book. And then also this one he just got for his birthday. I'm not sure who purchased it for him, but whoever did, thank you very much. He is obsessed with it. But this one's called Come Over to My House. So we'll be bringing this one as well. And then the last thing I have is just this little pack of stickers I got from the Target's Dollar Spot. It comes with 24 little sheets of stickers. So I thought this would be good for them to play with in their plain notepad. They can put in the notepad or do anything with them. I don't know. I just thought stickers would be a great option. And then I'll probably go in their crafts bin and pick out a few more stickers, because they do already have some stickers at home, and also put that in our bag. I'm going to be bringing this tote bag, and this is where I'm going to put all of their like activities and stuff in to keep it kind of organized. I'm sure everything will be get thrown around the car, but to try to keep it organized, I'm just going to bring this bag as well. And that's everything that I will be bringing with me on this 8-hour road trip. But I did want to tell you guys a few other things that you can bring on a long road trip if you guys need ideas. Another thing that I was thinking about doing is getting those little window clings. They sell them at Target and I think even Dollar Tree. Basically, it's just window clings that you can put on the window, so they can put on the inside of the car window and just play and like organize it and stuff. So that's another great option, is getting window clings for the window. Another thing is puzzles. And I was thinking about getting a puzzle, but I didn't get the tray. They have like these travel trays that you can put on your lap for kids in the car, and I think it even has a cup holder. So I'll try to find one. I'm not sure what the name is. I'll try to find it on Amazon and link it down below for you guys. And I was gonna buy one of those for Ryan and then bring him these little travel puzzles that I have bought from Dollar Tree that he loves, but I never got that tray, so I won't be bringing puzzles. But if you do have that tray, puzzles is always a really great option, although I guess they can get lost in the car. But I usually buy the ones that only have like 15 or 20 pieces and comes like in a really small tin. So I think that is another great option that you guys can bring for your kids in the car. And the last thing I want to share with you guys that is a great option to bring in the car for your kids is called, I think, Roadside Bingo. I found it at Dollar Tree and I did recently see it there, so they do still have it. And I think they have maybe like three different types of it. Basically, it's bingo that you play in the car. So you have to find like a stop sign, or it's find a certain tree or a certain animal, and you just play bingo in the car. And I thought that was really cute. It was a road game. So like I said, they did have like three different ones that I saw, and I did just see it at Dollar Tree the other day, so they do still have it in stock. So that was another great option for your kids in the car if they want to play roadside bingo. All right, guys, so that is the last idea that I have for you guys. If you guys are traveling with little ones and you need a few ideas to keep them entertained and occupied while traveling, hopefully I could have helped one of you guys out, because I know traveling with little ones isn't always the easiest, especially if you're traveling alone. You definitely need all the help that you can get. So hopefully I could have given some of you guys a few ideas to do with your little ones while traveling. And as always, I just want to say thank you so much for watching today's video. If you have not already, please hit the subscribe button, subscribe to my channel. I would love to have you join my YouTube family, and also give this video a thumbs up, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.